If you look at the higher primates, bonobos, chimps most notably, you do find what I think is a very impressive ability to communicate. Now, it's not typically through vocalizations. One of the curious things that distinguishes humans from non-human primates is that we have a very fine control over our mouths, our articulators, in fact, even our ability to breathe. I'm told by primatologists that if you drop a chimpanzee in a swimming pool, it'll sink like a stone. They can't be trained to hold their breath. But they can communicate manually through sign language, and they can understand spoken language. So Kanzi, who's a bonobo that's very well studied, I want to show you a bit of what Kanzi does, and then ask you to think about how to understand that. This is Kanzi as a cute little bonobo baby. Cute little bonobo babies grow up to be not so cute bonobo adults. And this is Sue Savage Rumbaugh, who has worked with Kanzi over many, many years to teach Kanzi to sign and, in fact, to understand her language. So let's look at a clip of Sue Savage Rumbaugh in the kitchen with Kanzi working together.
I got the onions in a bowl. Let's go put them in our hot food and we'll come back and turn the TV on. Get your onions right here and put them in your bowl. Look, you spill some of them.
The chimps have responded well to such a rich environment and show an unprecedented grasp of spoken English.
Let me get you a spoon to start with, Kanzi.
In addition to spoken language, they receive a steady stream of nonverbal cues, attention-directing maneuvers, and repetition, the hallmarks of the way we speak to young children.
Yeah. Will you wash this potato off for me? Could you wash the potato?
Sue Savage Rumbaugh is convinced that the combination of all these everyday interactions at an early age is essential for the acquisition of language. Scientists call this process enculturation.
All right, your noodles are going to go in here, and you can have a few of them for your tummy. Kanzi, could you turn the water off again, please? Turn the water off, please.
In the kitchen, in Sue's company, Kanzi functions impressively. But does Kanzi, like a human, really have the ability to understand words?
And that's the question. What is it exactly that Kanzi understands? Now, I take it as very impressive that Kanzi can function in a kitchen and interact with Sue in all of the things that are needed to do to cook. Kanzi spent a lot of time in the kitchen, so this is not the first time Kanzi has done this. But put yourself in Kanzi's place, or better yet, put yourself in some unfamiliar language context. Pick Farsi or Hungarian, and imagine you were working with a Farsi speaker and you knew a few words, onions, water, things like that. You probably would get fairly far and be able to do the kinds of things that Kanzi did, based on the knowledge of a few words and based on knowing what's appropriate behavior. Okay? So without meaning to belittle or diminish the impressiveness of what Kanzi's doing, it's probably, this at least is not a conclusive demonstration that Kanzi is able to use language in any of the complex ways that we normally think about it. And we'll talk a bit about what that might mean.